What is up, everyone? Welcome back to PowerPoint for Scientists. In this lecture, we're going to see how we can present data either in form of a table or a chart in the most effectively way. Because you can have the best data in the world of the most groundbreaking science discovery, but without presenting it in the most engaging or easy to understand way, you will lose the audience in your presentation. So in this lecture, we're going to see how we can present your data in the most visually engaging and easy to understand way. I think we've all seen this kind of table in the scientific presentation. It's like the author just copy it straight from their publication and paste it in the presentation slides and ask the audience just to look at the specific number or create a red circle surrounding that number and ask the audience to ignore the rest of the number. So I always question like why they put that number there if they don't talk about that. So the first quick way to fix that is create a different shading of the number you don't talk about. You can see right away your eye will be drawn to the one that in the darker color. The second way to add to is create the shading and different color. You can see that your eye will jumping back and forth between left and right because our brain always pick out the most contrast in the picture. So using this technique, you can precisely control where the eyes of the audience gonna stop, and then you will talk about that number and explain your data in a very effectively way. So you can see that we can turn this busy table to a more ease for the brain way of presenting your data. Because the human brain just can focus at one information at a time. So we should not distract the attention of the audience by giving them tons of data at one time. Another way to further improve is create different intensity of the shading according to the intensity of your data. So right away you can see which data is the highest number and which is the lowest number. So this is also another option. The best option is use the picture instead of the numbered data. So just spend some time to convert your data table into a chart or graph, so it will help the audience to visualize the data very fast. So in the next section, we're going to see how we can improve the chart in your presentation. So I will go to Excel file. For example, I have this data table over here. So if you have your data every day, like a pH over here, I measure it every day. So what chart you're going to use, you go to chart and insert a line chart or line with marker. Since I measure it every day, I can just use the line chart to show the trend of the pH every single day like this. And I will add in select data and change this name to pH. And I create another series. So name is, for example, I measure the acid concentration. So this acid, I don't measure it every day. So I need to present it in a different way with the data I measure every day. For example, I choose this same with the amount of day. I measure the pH. I select it, press enter. Because I don't measure it every day, so show empty cell as I will connect all the data points. I don't want to create a gap, I want to create a trend between different data points. So I'll connect data point with line. And now I have a second series in the red color. So I click in here, you can see that all the data point is separate and connect by the line. I will right click and edit it. I can set this to the second axis on the right. So you can see that the left axis is for the pH and the right axis is for the acid. What I can change here, I will create a solid line in the orange color. So you can see that the orange line here, and what I need to do is I will create a marker for them. Go to marker. And marker option, I can increase the size of the marker here for more. So you can see that the marker with the line and very nice separate to different axes. And I can add the name right going here, add chart data, the name on the left, name on the right, and name in the x-axis for the day, different day. And now I can change the name here. And another thing I can do is I will change the font. So normally I would use Helvetica font. I would prefer the Sans Serif font for easy to read in the, because it's the short text. So this will be Acid, and the other one will be PH. And another thing you can do when you create a chart with two different axes is you will color code your chart. You can see the chart is blue color, so I would choose this text to become blue color. So right away the audience will know like, oh, that blue color will read in the left axis and the orange color will read in the right axis. So this is a fast way to, you don't have to create like an arrow that pointing to the left or to the right. And even in the black and white figure, so here you can see I'm saving it as a picture. I will show you even in the black and white or in the publication, you can still see it. I will reduce the saturation to turn it to black and white. So you can say like the smooth line is for the pH and the one with marker is for the acid. You can put that in the legend or in the note under your figure. So that is one quick tips even for your presentation as well as for your publication for your paper. So you can see that you use the line chart for your training of your data if you measure it every day or if you have the batch experiment. So the best way, for example here, I have the average of a different day of information. So the best chart for this type is the bar chart. So you can see here, for example, I create the average and standard deviation for 10 days of my last 10 days of my experiment. So the best way to present this kind of data is in the bar chart. So here I go to insert, I click here, go insert, and I will choose a bar chart like this. And I can add the standard deviation, go to insert, and choose the more error bar option. So I choose both up and down with the bar and choose the custom. So here I will choose the standard deviation. So for the upper, for the lower it's the same, so I just copy and paste it down here. And okay, and when zoom in you can see you have the mean value and the error bar represent the standard deviation. You can say that under the figure annotation. So that is the second type of the chart for the average data or just for the different replication of your experiment. And for the different type of data, when you want to create like a regression, the correlation between two different results, the best kind of chart is a scattered chart. So over here I have the methane percentage and also the methane yield. So I want to create a correlation between these two type of information. I go to insert the scattered chart. You can see that this scatter chart take into account of the y-axis and the x-axis at the same time. So here you can add a trend line to make a regression line between these two data. So insert add trend line, it look like a linear for me. And you can add the formula by go back to add chart element, trend line, and more trend line option. So over here you can see linear. And I will tick the box of display equation and display R-square. So you can see that you have the regression equation and with the goodness of fit of 1 over here. So you have to be really careful because if you want the regression like this, you have to choose the scatter plot. Because before I choose this line with marker and And then I thought like the what this is the y-axis, and I can add the x-axis in the horizontal axis label. But this is totally wrong. You have to be careful not to make my mistake, because you can also create the trend line with this kind of graph, but this is not the right one, because they don't take into account of the x-axis. You can see that over here. If I put it no line, it look like the data on the left, and then I can add the trend line linear, and I can also go to add the equation, same with the scatter plot. And I also got the result of my equation and my R squared, but this result is wrong. You cannot use the line to create the regression. You have to use the scatter plot that take into account of the y's and the x-axis. So just a small note, if you guys already, maybe you already know this, but I just want to throw it in here. So quick way to fix, change it to the scatter plot. So next, I'm going to show you some of the example of the figure I create for my publication. So here you can see that I have three different condition, and each condition I have the mean value with the standard deviation with the statistic of a group A, B, C significantly different. On the right axis I choose the hot color, and on the left axis I choose the cold color for the color coding. And for the trend of my performance on different day, I create a line chart. You can see that the pH I measure every day and is read in the left axis, and the red chart is read in the right axis of I don't measure it every day, so it have the marker. So zoom in, you can see that you can use the color to code your result, and the audience will have very easy to know which axis to read the data on. And I also add two different shading, two box of color here to represent two different condition. So you can use that if you run your experiment with different condition, and add a note as well, like pH adjustment. For other resources of this kind of how to present your data, you can go to YouTube. One of my favorite is How to Avoid Death by PowerPoint. So this TED talk is very nice, show us how to present your information. And also for your chart presentation, just check out this plot.ly website. It's a free plotting website, so you can plot your chart. So this is one of the example of the chart I create in the 3D. So because I don't have the MATLAB or other paid application, so I just go to this website and create a 3D chart. And it's interactive, so I even can copy the link and paste it in my publication, so the audience, the reader can just click in and go to see all the data and to interactively see the chart. And they also have a different chart type, you know, click here and they have all the different chart types you can choose on, like a contour chart, the heat map, a scatter plot, or the map. This is one of my favorite. If you work on like geography or statistic, this is very nice, very interactively. You can have a different map of the USA or even a region like Asia, North America, or Europe. And after you put your data in, you will have a different heat map or color coded for different country. So please check it out to see if you like it or if it helps you in any way. So to wrap up this lecture, there are three things you need to remember. First, present one information at a time. Don't confuse your audience or don't overcrowd your slides with a lot of information like the data table. Just choose wisely and present one information and one conclusion per slide. Second, you can create a contrast between two axes of the chart, and chart is the best way to present your data. So create contrast between color, design, and you can present your data effectively. And the third thing you need to keep in mind is you have to design the slides so it will take the audience less than 3 seconds to understand the data and to understand what you're trying to convey in the data table or in the chart. Because as a rule of thumb, if it took longer than 3 seconds to understand your data, it indicates that your data table may be overcrowded or your chart may be need to be redesigned to maximize the effect of the contrast, the color, and the design. So if it's longer than 3 seconds, so redesign your slide and simplify it to have a more effective way of presenting your data. Thank you very much for your time, guys. I hope you guys learned something new today, and I hope to see you in the next lecture.